the old trick in the Glasgow docks, somehow there was always a case of whiskey that got slightly damaged. Yes. And that meant that the whole case had to be taken out of the delivery.
Yes. Yeah? I like
even
your thinking.
One bottle was broken. Yeah, the wine's gone as well. Here we go.
Documentation centre. Okay, this is the best part of the tour. This is when Daniel gets to run over some of the passengers from a rival ship. Yeah. And if we're really doing well, we'll bag a few cyclists on the way out. That's the way we're going to do it.
And we haven't said good morning to Daniel yet. Morning, Daniel.
Morning. Yeah, that, if they had any brain whatsoever, they would just walk a little bit in the other direction. But no, that's the Americans for you. Hopefully, no Americans on board. Okay. But just one question: any Kiwis managed to sneak on board? No. 100% Aussie, huh? Yeah. No. Irish, okay, that's allowed. Dutch, okay, that's okay. Some German. Yes, I'm extremely German, yes. Yeah, you've probably noticed by now. Yeah. I come from a place called Glasgow in Scotland. Never heard of it. And that's my hometown. But I came here I first came here 25 years ago, and I've lived here for 24 years, so I've got a reasonable idea what goes on here. No, Janet, but she's from Glasgow as well. Yeah. She's, I think, just about the same length of time here as I am. How did you manage to get all that information out of Janet in the space of about 2 minutes? Yeah. Well done. Okay, this is what I have to look at almost every Saturday morning. It's Saturday. Today's Saturday. Okay. Where did you begin? Up in Amsterdam? Yeah. Okay. And you're down to Budapest. All the way down to Budapest. Okay. Ah, yeah. I just love this part of the tour. Yeah. Now this bridge here, folks. This was built. Just slightly before the First World War, this bridge, and it's one of the most historical bridges. I'm only joking. No. I think it is. This is a modern bridge. Yeah. No. The Germans are not that progressive. Yeah. It's a 1960s bridge. Yeah. Yeah, one of the factors that's adding to the chaos a little bit here is that these Viking boats, these new ones that Viking have, they're a little bit bigger than what they've been working with before, and we have low water further down, and so they're having to bus up passengers and swap them over. So this ship will turn around here and go back up to Amsterdam. There'll be another ship that will turn around here. A medieval city wall that is still to this day 5 kilometers long, about 3.5 miles or so. And there is a city wall, a medieval city wall, defensive wall in Europe, which is longer than the Nuremberg wall, but only one. And that is down in Croatia, down in just outside Dubrovnik. 1916 courthouse building, stretching from the annex behind the unfortunately named pit stop there, all the way along. We'll also pass the flags of the four nations who took part in that international military tribunal. The United States, of course, it was pretty much their baby. They were in control of the whole thing. But the United States, Britain, USSR, and France. Now, most people jump to the conclusion that the reason why we had the trial taking place here was because the propaganda rallies had taken place here, but it was far from being the truth. the reason why. But if you go back 650 years, of course, this cemetery is much smaller. This is the oldest part that we're now passing. Much, much smaller, and of course it's surrounded simply by green fields and nothing else. There's no housing, there's nothing out here. This is one of the wagon train routes that runs in and out of the walled city. The walled city is about half a mile up ahead of us. And what you find is that the very first people who set up here are lepers and other chronically sick people, for the simple reason that they're banned from living in the walled town. They don't want, the city fathers don't want the spread of plague inside the city walls, so they're banished. They live on the approach roads. They set up their colonies, or they did set up their colonies on the approach roads running in and out of the town. And so the very first people buried in there were actually the lepers and other chronically sick. Look at where the buses come and go from the market square, just for your orientation for later when you come in and out with the shuttle buses, just so that you're familiar with where the buses come and go from. And then after we've done that, we'll make our way out to the former Nazi Party rally grounds.
150 Jews were slaughtered here in this area right here. Yeah? There used to be a little synagogue on the far side of the square. It was completely razed to the ground. In its place, from 1352 to 58, we had a Church of Our Lady constructed. And this was very often done after the pogrom, because this was rubbing salt into Jewish wounds, because the Jewish faith does not recognize Mary as being the Mother of God. And very often when a pogrom took place, this was done. A Church of Our Lady was built on the site of the former Jewish synagogue.
Here would have been clad in granite stone, the eternal stone. A cantilever roof would have been put on this building, with a glass section just over the entrance. And we would have had seating installed for 60,000 people. And this was the intention. It was never carried out. Most of the plans that they had for the rally grounds were never carried out. The Zeppelin grandstand, which is closed off today because of the motor racing, was completed. It's now, we still have the remnants of the Zeppelin stand. Apart from that, they had great plans for out here, but very little actually came to fruition. Now this, and I'll show you photographs of this once we leave the bus, folks. This, had it been completed, as I say, would have been a covered hall. 60,000 especially invited National Socialist members would have come here to listen to Adolf Hitler give a marathon speech. And that was the sole purpose for which this building was to be built. 364 days of the year it would have been locked up. When the rallies came and Hitler gave his speech, it would have been opened. Now the interior would have resembled some kind of giant cathedral, some kind of church. And although we see Hitler as being a political leader, in many ways he resembled something like the leader of a cult, some kind of demigod. And he himself considered himself to be the Messiah come to rescue Germany, to take Germany out of the doldrums. And so he would have stood on his pulpit above us, where at the front of the bus here, a glass section, and the light, the spirit, would have entered the building, similar to a Renaissance cathedral. And immediately above the door here, they had plans to give another church-like feature to this building. The world's largest pipe organ was to be installed. Now, the National Socialists, they had no truck really with religion of any kind, but they knew that religion and its ritual played an important part in Christian Germany's life, and so they wanted to retain some elements of that, and so that's why it would have resembled some giant church-like structure. What you'll also find is that there are some of us, I include myself in this, I wouldn't have minded seeing this building finished, National Socialists defeated as they were, And then we could have invited some reprobates over here to sit and play the organ. You know, I don't think the National Socialists would have been all that keen on Liberace sitting at their organ, or Jerry Lee Lewis, or Elton John, or people of that nature sitting there. Yeah. Try not to speak too loud, but every room has one of these plaques telling you which room it is and the topic of the room. Every single room has one of these.
Cars, nothing really.
Okay, folks, city centre, 2 o'clock and 3 o'clock, but more importantly, for those of you who are staying in town, the bus is back from here to the ship, 2:30, 3:30, and the last one, 4:15. 2:30, 3:30, and 4:15, okay? And if anyone doesn't have one of these sheets with all the information on it, I don't need it anymore, so I can pass it on to someone. So just come and say, I want it. And now we'll see just where we can park.
Definitely a commuter type of deal.